actually something to remind me of something else.
She'll be here for tea. But I'm talking about this place. call me Joe. You don't call me Malcolm, man. Hey.
Joe.
Call me Joe. Ah. Call me Joe. Ah.
Joe.
Call me
Joe.
All right. Well, I think it's time for some tea.
Well, the tea?
Mmm.
Ah, it's all good with that now.
How do you have it?
Hey, I'll have eight milk and one sugar lad, hey.
Alf, tea?
No, no, you know, I don't like tea, Joe, you know. I'll have a glass of hot water with two ice cubes, please, Joe.
Oh, right.
Mmm, I've got one tonight, too. I hate tea, you know. I hate tea. Can't stand stuff. I can't stand tea, me, Joe.
You don't like tea?
No, I hate it. I tell him, you know, I tell him. He loves it.
Right.
He loves the stuff. You can't get enough of it, you know. He's a funny boy, he's a funny boy.
Oh, yeah.
I tell you what, Joe. When he was young, he weren't even able to speak properly.
No, but he not.
No. He always got his S and his S's mixed up, like, you know. Couldn't tell them apart, you know. So, if it were foggy, like, it's, yeah, you know, he'd be like, look at it, it's soggy, it's soggy. Yeah, you know. I tell you what, when we were young, he used to love playing in sand, you know, making sandcastles, like, you know, sandcastles. So, thank you, George. So, me and Sheila, we took our charge to the beach, right?
Yeah.
And we're making these sandcastles, you know, making sandcastles. And, you know, we're putting sand in buckets and turning them over, like, you know, and giving them tap. You know what special tap, Joe? So sand them crumble. You know what special tap? Good, isn't it? So you know what special tap? And we check off bucket, man. And these sand, they're perfect. They're perfect, Joe, you know. Sandcastles, they're perfect. And Charlie's loving it, he is, you know. He's giggling away, like, you know. And I said to him, I said, Charlie, I've got a surprise for you. You know, close your eyes. Right? Close your eyes. And he closes his eyes. And I get these three blue flags.
Right?
And I put them in top of each castle. Right? You know. And I said to him, I said, you can open your eyes now, Charlie. Open your eyes. But as he goes to open his eyes, Joe, there happens to be these three quite large women walking past us, you know, wearing them, you know, what, on the beach, what they call you, you know, what women wear.
What
women wear on the beach?
Costumes,
swimming costumes, wearing swimming costumes. and so they're walking past her, and I says to him, you can open your eyes, you know. But as he opens his eyes, and he sees these blue flags. He's loving, you know. He's laughing, or he's giggling, you know. And he points, you know, in direction of these castles and these lakes. And he goes, he blesses his little eye, you know. He goes, look at it, three flags.
Oh.
Three flags, he says. Bloody hell, fire. Sheila, we're mortified.
You're mortified.
I thought I'm going to get slapped round the face, you know. Well, thankfully, by grace, you know.
Did you know?
No.
Australia.
Eh?
What were you doing in Australia?
Yeah,
know about what we... What, want to know about the sailors in and this bitch.
Time ago, mate, now. We do stay. I do spin married. Do spin it to our Maggie. And we've gone married. I just scrubbed out first of all. I just got me captain in arm. Ah, did I go? Because I used to be captain. But just merchant.
He was captain, isn't he? I was in army, mate.
Ah,
he was in there.
Merchant, there, though. But that meant I'm the old shit. My own men, I've got a responsibility in army to go away for 14 years. Of course, we're after him, man, I'm not sure. Well, you know that. I used to go other places, yeah. I used to go to Africa, India, the Saudi, China, and, well, I went to, Australia now. Sailors in it. Goes in bad, quite nice, man, lad. Worked it bad and that. And goes up to that. And I says, excuse me, Barney, I have a Scotch with no eyes, that could be good Scotch hunt. And stood next to me with this bonnie Aussie bird. But bonnie, she was, I'm talking bloody long blonde hair, sunny blue eyes, that nice blue eyes, that nice body, and that, right? Yeah. not too big, lads, she clocks on to me. She sees me across the back, slick as jump. She leans over. She says, right, excuse me, Barney, whatever he's having, I'll buy. And I was like, hey, lads, bloody, no make a pen for me. I said, what do you have it? She says, Martini, I goes, and Martini, yeah. So I goes, right, Barney, whatever she's getting, I'll buy. And guess what? She wanted to have never give it out. She was stubborn like that. Stubborn. So she's like, right. Whatever he's getting, I'll buy. It goes on and on. We keep drinking this and bloody getting round in there. Drinking so bloody much that we end up leaving that pen a fucking damn, don't we? We're bugging off. I'm going to... Anyways, lad, I'll take it back to me, Kevin. Aye, I take it back to me, Captain, right, dog. Oh, she were white. She were bloody fiery. She were dark horse. She were fire. Bloody things did to me, but they break me in now, wouldn't they? Oh, she were fire. Wild she were. Hey, she didn't bloody say that now, though. She didn't steal anything. But she came round next night. And she stayed nights after that. And the nights after that, and the week after that, and bloody months of it. She said to bloody much that the rest of the crew tried to lock you up, Captain, bloody cheeky boss. Most think she could have been. If she were born a man, she could have been Captain. She was strong, she was. She was fine. If you get to last night, it was, we put off back to Britain next day, back and by. Me and lads decided to go out and... get back to the ship with him, and I go to the cabin, I'm a very skinful lad, I open my cabin door up, and well, there she was, she packed up all my room, she had bloody trousers in one bag, shirts and the full shebang. All of it, And see, she looks me dead in the eye. She does. Looks me in the eyes and she says, Malcolm, she says. And I ain't being called Malcolm, you know. Call me Joe. Call me Joe, eh? But Malcolm, she says, right stern. She says, you're coming with me tomorrow and we're getting trained to Melbourne. And I says, hey, lass. Bloody Melbourne, eh? Nae beggar tells me what to do, lass. I'm captain of this bloody boat. I'm going back to Britain to... Going bloody Melbourne with you? I've got to... I'm voyaging back to Britain tomorrow, aren't I? You stupid... I said, you stupid woman, I said. Silly bitch, I said. Look, not going to Melbourne with you. Look. Melbourne? Have I played that? Bloody... Not a word she's got to. What? Bloody Melbourne. You can piss off that town here. I'm not doing that. End this. Not... No. No way. Bloody Melbourne.
Why didn't you come with me?
You knew I couldn't come with you, lass. I told you about me wife, didn't I? I bloody said about me, sorry about my child. And I bloody captain, you silly bitch. I'm a captain of my own. I couldn't leave me crew. I couldn't leave me family or my crew. You knew that, love. You bloody knew that, love. You stupid woman. You don't. You can't ask me I knew that, love. You can't. You can't know that. Malcolm, she says. I love you, Malcolm. And if you love me, you'll come with me, won't you? I didn't say all that.
Anybody sat there?
Nope.
It doesn't look like it.
Oh, does. Good, good. I don't want any tea. Are you drinking tea? Oh, dear me. Oh, you're right.
Malcolm.
What's Malcolm doing? Malcolm, what are you doing?
Bloody Joe, that. I'm coming to show you picture of that lass. I've got to be Willie. I've got to be Willie.
Yeah.
Come and show buddy.
Well, I'm not
going to
get
to bullet. come here, John. Feast your eyes. Seen that lovely lady there?
Oh.
Look at her nice. Quite pretty.
Quite pretty,
eh?
Well, I'm married, you know.
What?
You know, to see. You know, she's me everything. She's me well, you know.
Yeah.
But if I wasn't married,
you know. If you weren't bloody married, eh?
If I wasn't bloody married,
didn't stop me getting to be the governor of that, eh?
You two have no respect for women.
Bloody respect for women? Yes, I respect women.
Where is it?
You shouldn't. No, it's not worth it. You shouldn't steal. I'm always telling you, shouldn't steal. Always telling you, you shouldn't steal. Good people.
Yeah, there we are. So I says, right. question, Atkin. No. She's getting a bit... And I says, is he handsome chap, Margaret? And she says, it for granddad, I can't. So that's an appropriate granddad, she said. So I says, well then, if you're not with him for his looks, he must have a big dick, eh?
You can't say that! You can't say that to your granddaughter, Joe!
Oh, I
bloody hell, fire! You can't say that to your granddaughter!
I says, as long as you find a lad as good as your granddad, eh? You can't go far. You can't go far. So, you know, she buggers off. She goes in. Back, she does. To our lady. And she's crying, bless her. You know, she's bawling. You know, but she's a bit of a bawling. And I said, what are you crying for, lad? What are you crying for? I need to find my painting out for that. Just need to find it. Is it over there with you?
No. What about Grace?
Over there, pal. Grace. It's over there. It's over there. I'll come get it. She was crying, she was so crying. I sat down, I wiped away tears at it, I sat down beside her. I took her out to food markets at night, didn't I? We sat down by canal and I made a laugh at it, didn't I? Yeah, she won't cry, then she will laugh.
I were overseas on duty when I had an idea like, you know. And I was stationed in Germany. It were after it was, they stationed me in Germany. In them days, you know, in them days, you signed up for two years. Mm-hmm. So I'd been in Germany for a year when I had an idea like. And Sheila and I, you know, we were struggling, you know. We were struggling, you know, because we weren't able to communicate to one of them very often, George, you know. I mean, she weren't able to know anything of me whereabouts, you know. So when I knew I was going to marry, you know, and when I got chance, right, you see, when I got chance, I wrote her a letter. She answers the door and she just froze, you know, she froze. So I asked her.
You still got that box? We go get it.
And she toppled off like, you know, and I just remember standing there and thinking, she waited. Sheila waited for me, you know. She opens box, and I get down on one knee. She pulls out a forget me, her favorite flower.
Sheila, will you marry me? Yeah, lads. Got a big call. We'll go celebrate, yeah?
And you know, Chris, she said yes. Happy as ever, we are. Happy as ever. What do you think of that?
Lovely story, Alf.
Back in my romantic days. Anyone chat in? No.
I just have one question.
I lost my slippers.
too loud, Alf. They don't like it.
Shut up, Jim.
after dinner, eh? You what, eh? You just watch the go, eh? You watch the work go, eh?
Joe, don't.
Well, no, come on now. You could have been married to her now, we know, Judge. No, but you could have had kids been out, Judge. You could have grandkids and all been out.
Joe.
You fucking wasted your life.
Michael!
What?
Are you all right?
Fine, Al.
Are you sure?
Yes. Doesn't mean it, does he?
Hell, it doesn't mean it. That's the thing about him, you know.
He just needs.
He's a nice man. He's a nice man. And he doesn't mean to be mean, you know. He doesn't mean to be mean.
So,
and George knows that, you know. George knows that, you know. He doesn't.
You don't mean for a day.
And she's there. You know, she's there.